I've got this really bad habit for a cop. Once I start working on a case, I can't think about anything else. I'm exhausted. I haven't gotten a wink of sleep all night. Something's bothering me about this murder, but I just can't seem to put my finger on what it is.
Hi, Carla. How you doing today?
Hi, Doug. Not too bad. Is Tyler here yet?
No, not that I know of.
So, ready for that big retirement?
Working on it.
Hey, Carla, can you tell your partner to pay me back that $100 he owes me? I've been waiting 6 months for it now.
Can't help you there, Jeffrey. Talk to him about it.
He's been avoiding me like the plague. Plus, you know, you're the only one he listens to.
Catch you later, Jeffrey.
Hi, Carla.
Hi, Garrett.
Oh, wait, Carla. I got some results back on the tests we did for that restaurant murder.
Great. As soon as Tyler gets here, we'll come and see you.
Okay. I'll be at my desk all morning.
Tyler is still not here. I'd better try to give him a ring. Tyler still hasn't gotten rid of this basketball. Funny, I thought I'd been pretty clear. Tyler hates it when anyone touches his stuff.
Yeah?
Know what time it is?
Oh, shit.
Get a move on. The waitress is coming this morning to flesh out the composite on the killer.
I'm on my way.
Stay a little longer.
Sorry, babe, but I really gotta go.
I'll make some coffee.
Okay, I'll grab a shower, get dressed, and then I'm out of here.
Hey, you're a good-looking guy, you know that? It's broad daylight outside. I think I'm a little early. A statuette of Sox, one of the characters in my favorite video game. Man, I love watching her when she's sleeping. I've known her for 2 years now. She still rocks my world the way she did the first time I ever saw her.
I thought you were in a hurry.
Hey, I always got 2 minutes for you, babe.
Only 2 minutes? It's all happened before. Kirsten, what's that supposed to mean? Classified file. So, it's a name associated with a case. Too bad. I would have liked to find out more. It's completely idiotic, but it helps me think.
Hi, Carla.
Hi, Frank.
Hey, Carla. Sleep well?
Sleep's a waste of time. I'll have plenty of time to sleep when I'm dead.
That's our Carla.
Captain Jones hasn't come in yet. I'll catch him later.
Hello, Inspector.
Hi, Carla. How are you?
Yeah, Carla, I'm on my way. Yeah, I know. No, I just had a little problem, so I'll... Yeah, okay, I'm right there.
Whew, girl. Okay, this time I really am out of here. Collection of Motown albums. I wouldn't swap them for CDs for all the gold in the world. Go back to bed, Sam. You're gonna catch a death of cold like that.
I'm not cold.
Sam, please don't start. I got no intention of dying today.
I'm sick of living in fear like this. Every morning I'm terrified that something's gonna happen to you.
I know how you feel, Sam. There's a lot of violence out there. But if nobody does anything, it's all gonna go to shit. We're gonna have kids someday. I wanna leave them a world that's a little better than the one we got now.
But why does it have to be you who's out there risking his life, Tyler? Why couldn't we just go to Florida and work with my family and live a normal life like everybody else? Why do I have to wonder if you're gonna die every day?
I grew up with violence and chaos in the streets, Sam. Now you want me to drop everything, go lead a nice, normal life? Well, I'm sorry, babe, but that ain't gonna happen. I belong right here, not in Florida.
Cause you should be starving.
I love you, Tyler.
Hi, Tyler. Oh, Carla's looking for you.
Yeah, I know. So, you ready for retirement, man?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Let it crawl.
Tyler.
Hey, Tyler, what do you know? Just the guy I was looking for.
Oh, shit.
You remember that $100 I loaned you about 6 months ago? I'd really like for you to get that back to me as soon as possible. Like maybe now, for example?
Jeffrey, I'm gonna be honest with you, man. I got no more money. I gave it all to charity in an effort to make the world a better place for you and for me.
That's real funny, Tyler. Now give me my $100 before I get really pissed.
Yo, let me make you a deal. I'll play you a game of b-ball for your $100. If you win, I'll give you $200 right then. But if you lose, we cool.
You'll give me $200 if I win.
You got my word, man.
All right, you're on. But don't even think about not paying me if you lose, because that...
Don't worry, Jeffrey. I'll come by and see you when I get 5 minutes. The waitress hasn't come in yet?
She won't be long. Garrett got the lab results. Shall we go?
All right, let me hang up my coat. I'll be right with you.
Okay. See you in a minute.
Tyler, what's new?
So, what do you want to start with?
Tell me about the blood found in the killer's booth.
As strange as it might sound, that blood didn't come from the victim.
It was the killer's?
So it would seem.
He was wounded?
What did you find on the knife?
Got some good prints off it. They matched those found on the fork and glass at the suspect's table.
So, the murderer was definitely at that table.
Anything on the blade?
I'm getting to that. We definitely had blood from the victim, but the weird thing is we also found blood from the killer.
Were there any prints on the book that was under the table?
Yep, and they matched the ones on the fork and the glass. So it was definitely his book. It looked like a fairly old book. Maybe we can get some more stuff out of it.
Did you find anything on the coffee cup?
The only prints we found belonged to the waitress.
That's impossible, man. That cup was half empty. Somebody must have drank it.
What about the pool of blood in the stall?
You're not going to believe this. The blood wasn't from the victim. It was from the killer.
What was he doing bleeding in the stall?
I have absolutely no idea.
Did you get the list of calls that came through the telephone at the restaurant?
Yep. There were about a dozen in the 4 hours that preceded the murder. I'll send you a list by email. So, what do you think about all that?
I don't have any explanation for the blood in the stall. The victim could have wounded the killer during a struggle, but it doesn't make sense that it would be in the stall. It's as though the killer wounded himself.
Hey, why not? You get clumsy fools in every other profession. Why not killers?
That's kind of a flimsy explanation, Garrett.
To each his own, Carla. I do the testing, you figure out the reason why.
Thanks for your help, Garrett. See you later.
So, what do we do now?
You go take care of the composite. I'm gonna go check with the coroner and see if he got anything from the body.
Okay. Catch you later.